Welcome back to Cinema Greats. I'm your host, Harrison Foster. This week, we visit the dark side with Cinema Greats' top five scariest movie villains of the past 50 years. Creeping in at number five, we have Jafar from the 1994 film Disney's Aladdin. With his swooping cape and deep hypnotic voice, Jafar frightened millions of cinema buffs everywhere. The prospect of this amoral psychopath becoming an all-powerful genie is almost too frightening to bear. At number four, prepare to recoil in horror from the guards from Disney's Aladdin. This spooky phalanx of nameless lawmen torment our hero, young Aladdin, through the streets of Agrabah, chasing his harmless street rat all over a loaf of bread. Yet surely they were once like us, valuing human connection over a blind allegiance to law. We ask ourselves, could that be me? And the terrifying answer returns not from the screen, but from within. That already is me. Now, some viewers might be expecting a Freddy Krueger or a Hannibal Lecter as we roll into number three, but hypothetically, if those same viewers had spent the years of 1994 through 2009 in captivity with nothing but a VHS of Disney's Aladdin and their nameless captor known only as the Blood Keeper, well then, hypothetically, those same viewers might recognize that the third scariest movie of all time is the cruel, dastardly genie from Disney's Aladdin. Truly, the most evil thing you can do to someone is try to solve all their problems for them. That never helps in the long run. Let's revisit our hypothetical captive in, what did we say it was, warehouse basement in Everett? Now, if some genie just waltzes in and fixes everything for him, he'll never learn how to wait until some teens find him while looking for a place to smoke. For the dastardly genie to swoop in and fix everything would render our hero's suffering meaningless, which is absurd because suffering has meaning. Now, no list of spooky movie villains would be complete without an evil demon child, wicked beyond his years. Here at number two, we have Jonathan Taylor Thomas from the trailer for Disney's Man of the House at the beginning of the VHS of Disney. This wicked creep in the guise of a teen idol plays all manner of fiendish tricks on his mother's new boyfriend, played by poor Chevy Chase. Well, I bet if he knew that Chevy Chase was going to disappear for 15 years, he might appreciate the time they spent together a little more. Or maybe his mom just moves on right away, and now Todd is his real stepdad. Evil JTT! Behind those demonic blue peepers lurks the kind of wickedness that would frighten even someone who had lived his own personal version of Stephen King's Misery. But enough about the greatest comedies of the past 50 years. Imagine a captor who actually likes your novel. Harsh notes, Bloodkeeper. And we've reached number one. Now, if you're like me, you're the type to jerk awake night after night in an ice-cold sweat, shrieking in a language somehow harsher than German. And it's definitely this icon of the macabre that's been haunting your dreams. The number one villain has always been you, yourself. The horrors of this world only become real when filtered through our own dark perception. Sure, you may be chained to a radiator by outside forces, but the real villains will always be in the mirror. I'm just kidding. Number one is the bird. Parrots.